Hi, everyone. And this is my friend Joe. Joe, what have you been doing? And what do you have there?
I've been walking in the woods and looking under dark stones and logs to see what nature I can find. So I'm using this torch to shine a light in all the dark places.
That's a good idea, especially when it's dark walking in the woods. It's very important to find your way on trails. Do you know that you are like a light, Joe?
I'm a light? What do you mean? I don't have a switch, do I?
No, silly Joe, you don't have a switch. But the Bible tells us that you are the light of the world. God wants us to be the light of the world. Jesus was a great light who came from God.
I think I remember a story about light in the Bible.
You're so right. Yes, in Matthew, Jesus said, "You are the light of the world. A town on a hill cannot be hidden, nor do the people put a light on it and then cover it. Instead, they put a light on it so everyone can see it."
Hiding a light when it's needed seems a bit silly. Then no one can see anything.
Yes, and Jesus says, "Let your light shine so that others can see your love and kindness in your good works and give praise to the God." Philippians chapter 2 tells us that we shine like stars in a dark world.
I love the stars at night. They look amazing, how they twinkle.
Yes, and you're a bright light to the world that can be spiritually dark. When you live your life loving others and telling them about Jesus, you bring the same bright light into their lives too. The Holy Spirit helps us to do that. The Holy Spirit and the Bible is a bit like your church. Psalms 119 says, "God's word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path."
That reminds me of a song.
Does it?
I used to sing it. "This little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine." Shall we sing it?
Yes. And you're going to carry on, help us.
Here we go.
Everyone.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.